Welcome to the press conference for the San Marino Grand Prix for Formula Custom Challenge. In first place, El Fernandez driving for Martini Fernandez Racing. In second, Roman Canardo driving for Scuderia Ferrari, and Dr. Nico 97 also driving for Scuderia Ferrari. So El Fernandez decides to boycott the press conference.
He's quickly gone off, hasn't he?
He's gone for a quick.
I think he's gone for a shit. Right. Okay.
All right. So Fernandez, you had a pretty boring race until the end. Actually, you mean dominating for pretty much most of the race until that red flag.
Well, the first part of the race definitely it wasn't easy at all. We had a few safety cars. I had a bad start at first, actually. I had a bad start and dropped down second, and then we had the whole safety car scenario, so technically it wasn't easy, but then it came to the pit stages, and definitely I was the first to pit, so that set the pace more or less for the rest of the race, set the position more like, and it became, it just, the gap grew, and I was more interested in what was going on behind me after a while than I was in my own race. I did have a frustrating time behind Kyle, who hadn't actually pitted at all yet. I knew he wasn't in my race at that point. I didn't expect him to be lining up next to him with the five laps to go. And then obviously that red flag happened, and, well, yes, there was little pee in the pants, but it was all right, especially at the last corner. It was a bit but anyway, win. I couldn't really ask for any more. New team, well, I say new team, it's the same team, but new car, new sponsor, new engine, new everything, really, for the start of the new custom era. I couldn't really ask any more, really. Go ahead.
With the absence of Luca, who would you say would be your main challenger, considering Luca didn't make it?
I think Luca obviously would have challenged much more, but definitely the Ferrari guys proving today that had a lot of pace, especially Carl rubbing me up the wrong way every single race we do. But definitely the Ferrari guys. They had a battle but amongst themselves, so I think that really helped me get away. I'm quite impressed by the Benetton, definitely, because, we just didn't expect it to be that far up the field. Definitely them three, mainly, probably, it will be me, Carl and Luca, and Nico as well, so, yeah.
Final question, what would you say about your teammate this race? I mean, you had an interesting race, a bit up and down.
He had an up and down one. Apparently, he said he had problems with the car. My car was fine. He had the same car as me. And I don't know, the race wasn't going his way after a while. I feel he was a bit immature about it, definitely. He did actually get a better start, but obviously he cocked up on the restart. So that kind of meant obviously he got the penalty and went back, and then he kept fighting through. The guy is very fast. He's just very, as I said, immature and needs to kind of think a little bit more in the future, but it's only the first race, so we can't take much of that. Obviously he didn't score points, so that's that's helped Ferrari in the constructors. But yeah, I mean, that's pretty much all I can say about his performance. I have to wait until next week because what he did this week wasn't exceptional.
Okay, so moving on to Rambo. Good start to the season. You got second place, almost winning. I think you're like just a couple of centimeters away from victory. But good race overall, wouldn't you say?
Yes, I would say.
You had a very good battle with your teammate and Bongos. Just talk us through that. Ammo. Right.
I think he's gone for a nap.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I'll try one more. I'll move on to Nico first. Nico, debut podium. Good race from you. He had a very good battle with your teammates and Bongos. Just talk us through your race.
Yeah, well, there were a few hairy situations, like the collision with a Benetton and a few collisions with my teammate, but that's how racing works. It's always a bit risky. I hope the if I'm honest, I hoped for Rambo and LA to collide in the last few laps so I could pass them, but, well, because they were battling like hell. That was real racing, and I just tried to not to fall away too much. And yeah, I'm pretty glad that I managed to pass Bongo at the pit stops. I think I chose right. I'm very happy that Ferrari got the second and the third place.
And yeah,
as well as technically first.
Yeah. good start to the season. Would you hope for a win this season? Do you think you can get a win with your pace?
I think if I'm very lucky, I could score a win, but I've got obviously pretty tough company. And
yeah,
well, as said before, Luca wasn't here, and also Nick No wasn't here. So I think I will have pretty tough company if I want to win a race. It would just be, I think it would depend on the strategy of the pit stops and if they take each other out or not.
Okay, I'm going to go back to Rambo to see if he's back yet.
Yes, I am Rambo. Back.
Okay, you kind of disappeared for a bit.
yeah, sorry. Just
before I was asking, you had a good battle with your teammate and Bongos. Got second place. Talk through your race.
I think it was really interesting. I didn't mean to fight with my teammate. It was just kind of lag, I suppose.
Yeah. You had a brief stint in the lead having a vape after your second pit stop when you pitted very late. What was the plan behind that? Was there just any tactic on that? Or
there wasn't a real tactic. Just kind of to keep the position and hold out for as long as possible.
Yeah, it almost worked. I mean, you almost came ahead of Bongos and your teammate.
Yeah?
Yeah, but after getting second place, do you think you can get a win this season? I mean, you've shown to challenge for victory already.
Yeah, no doubt about it. I can get a win.
Okay, now moving on to the people on the floor. Who to start off with? The service is free and confidential. Okay, Crank. So, Crank, you had a good race. I mean, well, you had an interesting fight with your teammate. The car doesn't seem that quick, but what you play is there any issues with the car? Is it just lack of pace on it?
I think it might have just been lack of pace and getting taken out by Devin a lot. I think it might have been that. But the cars were running fine. I was actually closing in, so was Lepe. And they were just too fast for us today.
Yeah. You got double points for Jordan. I mean, that's a good result for this first race.
Yeah, it's good indeed.
Yeah. I mean, after Imola, do you, we've got Donington Park next. Do you expect your car to do better there?
Lefe and I are definitely going to be working a lot more on the car and making it better and faster so we can keep up with pace.
And final question, there was some team orders, I think, about lap 30. Was it any reason behind that? Or?
Oh, there was no team orders whatsoever. I never talked to him during the race.
Okay. Okay, moving
on. I think he just didn't want to take out a teammate, so he just pulled over.
Okay.
Because I had tremendous pace and I was trying to catch up with the lead group.
Alright. Okay, moving on to who's next? Who wants to be next? Alright, so Jumbo.
quickly may I add before we do anything, after this, if anyone from the floor wants to ask any question to the top three, they may.
Yeah. Okay, all then right. Jumbo then Ruby. Right, Jumbo, you had a couldn't really have a worse race, to be honest.
Yeah.
What happened?
Well, from my point of view, we've just had a little chat, me and Racing, and he said that his car had problems going into the corner, so he said he cut the corner and hit me, and then, I think James didn't see it properly, so he gave me the penalty, but yeah, what's happened has happened, and you can't really do much about it.
Yeah. I mean, you were a bit furious during the race, but at least you've calmed down now.
Yeah, I'm not, like, raging like earlier.
Final question, obviously you're hoping better in next round. Do you think you can get some points?
I don't just think I can. I know I can. At least 1 point. Well, it depends if you get disqualified in all the races.
All right, moving on to Bobby. Wait, did we add him to the...
Bobby.
All right, you've had a very up and down race. I mean, you were challenging for the podiums, then you just got a load of just caught up in collisions, and then right to the end, you just had to run the car.
Yeah, the steering went wrong.
Was there just any issues with that, or was it just...
Some car got stuck underneath the floor, and it lifted up the front end. I don't know how I did that, but...
That's odd. Well, I think we have an investigation into that. But talk us before that. You had a big battle with the Ferraris and Bongos.
It was a good battle. I just got annoyed with Bongos in the end. So. I mean, yeah, he wrecked my race, and I wrecked his, and I got the blame for it. So there you go.
Yeah, but obviously your car looks quick. I mean, you got front row. Do you hope you can get podium, win next race?
I'm not going to be ambitious, but I hope that I can finish outside the points again. Next race. Yeah.
All right. Alright, then quickly go to Crank, because I think he wanted something to add to his interview.
Oh yeah, it was just about the pace thing. The only reason why I lost pace was due to the drive-through penalties. First one where I was catching up on the lead group, I would actually give them that one, but the second one, it was just unacceptable by the officials. It was clearly his fault.
The pit lane one?
Yeah, he turned into me when I had the...
Well...
He should have backed off.
Talking from an official point of view, it was my colleagues who gave the thing, but I didn't see the incident, so I'll have to talk about that.
Yeah. I might have to talk to the official about that too.
Alright. Anyone else for interviews? Take it as a no.
Questions
from the floor. Questions from the floor.
I have a question for Nico.
Yes.
How was your restarts? Because you would seem to not go as fast on restarts as the Ferraris or the Hondas would. What happened at the restarts?
Well, at the yellow flag restarts, I sometimes I missed a little bit of a green because one time I was caught behind Jumbo and Rambo because Jumbo still had to pit, but hadn't yet, and he just pulled over to let Rambo and me through, to be fair. And yeah, he kind of did hit the corner wrong, and that kind of messed up a restart. And I think the red flag restart, I just messed up on taking the gas at the right time.
Okay, any more questions from the floor?
Yeah,
questions.
Yes.
Bobby,
you
first.
Go first.
Question for Rambo.
Carl?
What happened between you and Mid when you crashed together?
I can't exactly recall because I've got some bad memory, but I think he kind of lagged and I got into him and then just something weird happened.
And then in the end, we tried to get the cars off and then...
Right. Any other questions from the floor?
Rambo.
Yeah. This is for Rambo again. If you had 10 laps on, do you think you could have overtook LA?
Yes. No doubt about it.
If so, then what lap would you think that you would have overtook?
Oh my god!
Whenever I got the chance.
Well,
that's kind of ambitious, but I...
I have a question for Rambo.
Well planned.
If you had pitted earlier, would have you been able to take the lead and win?
Probably not.
No.
Unless luck was in my favor.
Right.
If you
okay,
had
any more...
chased, wait, I'm continuing. If you had chased Ale and then go in the same pit at the same time, you could have just spammed random numbers and just got in front of him. Because that's what I kind of did with Devin. and,
No, the thing is, I was already behind him. I was already behind him before he pit.
He was, like, right behind
him. Yeah,
I
was right behind him, so I had already
pit. A cheat.
Right, any questions for Ali? Because we haven't said any questions for
Money. Me.
I like how it's like, oh, let's just have a sympathy question going.
Yeah.
Do you think you can win the championship without another win?
I think
if you came second or...
Can't do a kick at Wolfsburg in this league.
I don't know, I would have to have the most flukiest winners every single race. I mean, we would have to have a different winner each race in order for
that
to happen.
Racing winning and then, like...
We would have to have it. Like, for example, Carl would win, then Nico would win, then Nick would win, then Luca would win, and then maybe, I don't know...
Me!
Crank would win, or Bongers would win, and then somehow, you know, and I would have to finish second each race in order to do that, and...
A racing lover would win.
I don't know what you're talking about.
If racing lover gets a win, I will give him a drive, okay? That's just... I'm saying that right here. He gets a drive. Because... I don't see it happening, but...
Go on, another question for Ali.
Yeah, another question from me. How many rounds are the left?
This was round one, so we've got 7 to go.
Got 8 rounds. I thought we had like 20.
Sorry, we have 10. Not bad. Nine.
Oh, nice going.
Oh god, this
I can go through the.
It must be the exhaustion from the race.
I can go through the calendar for you if you want.
Wait, can
people
yes, please.
Right. Okay.
Now, wait. Someone had a question before. I'm asking Nico. It's Nico to Ali. Ali, do you think that your participant turns FCC into form of follow?
If any lap is, if the last lap is by any indication, then no. definitely not Formula Follow because we had, what was it, second to fourth battling for the whole race? It was second to fifth.
Yeah.
For,
it doesn't matter.
For half the race, yeah. So by far not following at all. I think definitely next race is a more, it's a bit more of a varied track. This is quite... The track we went to had quite hard corners to overtake. It's just traditionally hard to overtake. The next track we've got is a bit more opportunistic. It's a bit of a half and half.
I think we'll have a track guide for that.
Yeah, it's a street circuit and then a normal circuit towards the end.